I really thank the Lord Jesus Christ that today, you know, I can share, you know, my miracle with you, you know, in the in this video. I think most of you probably have read, you know, a section of the book, you know, on me, you know, and the Elpiso Cancer Support Group, you know. But now Evelyn Tan has asked me to share more, you know, through this video, right? I think, you know, God really is amazing, you know. He really can perform miracles. As you can see, many miracles in Evelyn Tan's book, you know. I'm just one of the miracles, you know, by the Lord Jesus Christ, you know. Really, all glory to Him, you know. And, you know, actually, I just want to say that, you know, I was a Christian when I was young, many, many years ago. But I was such a lukewarm Christian, you know. I was, I don't know what to say, lousy Christian, you know. And on looking back, I'm quite ashamed of myself, you know. What? I call myself a Christian, you know. And, you know, I don't really behave like Christian, you know. So, how did I, you know, become close to Jesus? How did God change my life, you know? It was not until, I tell you, until the year 2006, you know. In 2006, how old was I? I was 50 years old. 50 years old, though, right now. That's the time, you know, I was struck down with four-stage cancer, you know. When I was struck down with four-stage cancer, this cancer was a relapse, you know. It was a relapse, you know, because when I was 38 years old, I already had this breast cancer third stage, you know. Yeah, and after all the chemo and radiotherapy, I went back to work for 12 years. So 38 to 50 years old is 12 years, right? And in 12 years, my goodness, cancer came back, cancer relapsed, you know? And this time, it was the fourth and the last stage, you know? And where has it spread to? It has spread to the lymph node, you know, right here on my chest wall, on the left-hand side, you know? And it was, you know, so huge, you know, the cancer tumor. You see the size of my fist? This is huge, the size of my fist, you know, and it's 6 by 7 by 4 cm, lodged between the heart and the lung, and it cannot be operated. Because once I'm operated, it's taken, torn out, I will die on the operating table, you know, right? Mm-hmm. Can you imagine? That's huge, a cancer tumor. It also spread to the whole chest wall over here, and this piece of bone called the sternum. Mm-hmm. You know, it was a very frightening experience when I looked at the CT scan. So full of cancer cells, spread so much of the body, and it was the fourth and last stage. And I know that most fourth and last stage cancer patients die within 1 or 2 years, or some just a few months, you know, like a couple of my friends, you know. So I was very frightened. I said, God, I cannot die, I cannot die. I was only 50 years old, feel so young, huh? Who wants to die at 50, right? Oh my goodness, no, right, no. So I quickly went into chemotherapy and radiotherapy. And after all the chemo and radio, you know, in 2006, 9 months of chemo and therapy, radiotherapy, a scan was done, you know. And it was most disappointing, the results. Because, you know, the tumor was still this large, the size of my fist, 6 by 7 by 4 cm. It didn't even go down by 1%. Can you imagine that? And the whole chest wall and the whole piece of sternum still flooded with cancer cells, you know. I said, oh my goodness, you know, right? And the doctor said, you know, Sherry, I've done all that I can. You just go back, live one day at a time and enjoy your life. That's it. My goodness, when this is said to you, imagine if this is said to you, a doctor say this to you, what does this mean? It means that I don't have long to live. It means that I will leave the earth, leave my husband, you know, and my family just very fast, within a few months. That's what it means, you know, right now. Yeah, I couldn't take it. No, I said, no, God, I'm only 50 years old, I cannot die, you know. But I remember that day after the doctor told that to us, my husband and I went back. We hugged each other so tight, you know. For 3 days and 3 nights, we cried and cried and cried, buckets of tears, you know, right? I tell you, right? We couldn't let each other go because we really thought I was dying already. Yeah. And, you know, straight away I thought, hey, my chemotherapy failed, my radiotherapy failed. So there was only one way to go. And I coined this thing called the word therapy, right? The word therapy, the word, is Jesus, right? The word is Jesus. Jesus is the say. I am life, and my word, right now, is spirit and is life, and it's health to a man's whole body. That's what the Bible says, you know, right now. Wow, I remember that. So I, coined the word therapy every morning. I will wake up at 5 a.m. I will seek the Lord, and I will. What do? Worship. Because worship usher in the presence of God. I've never really worshipped intimately with God. It was only when I was struck down with this four-stage cancer. I had no way to go. I wanted to live. know, right now. So I just, know, right, worship the Lord, usher in the presence, know, right now, from 5 a.m. to 8, 9, know, and the whole day, in fact, you know. And after ushering the presence, now I will read the Bible and then I will pray. Right? Prayer is very important. That connects my spirit, know, with the Spirit of God. And the Holy Spirit will come. The Holy Spirit will come from heaven, from on high, you know, when we pray, you know. Yeah. And you know, what happened, you know, right now? I just went on like that every morning, you know, worshiping God, you know, read the Bible, you know, I know, and read the Bible, and what do I do? You know, I just, you know, pray and pray. And one morning, as I was praying, the Lord, you know, downloaded into my heart one particular verse, you know, and that verse was Psalms 107:20. Psalms 107:20 says, "I sent my word and healed your disease. I will rescue you from the grave." You know, I said, "Oh my goodness, God, you can rescue me from the grave means I don't have to die, you know, right? You know? So, you know, you sent my word and healed my disease. You did not say you're going to heal my disease. You did not say I will, you know, heal your disease. You say I already healed your disease, you know? Healed, past tense, you know, truly, you know, right now. That's why we believe that 2,000 years ago, you know, God died for us, you know, and sent his son Jesus to die for us, you know. And by his stripes we are healed. That's why you see, he said we are healed. So God said, I sent my word and healed your disease. I will rescue you from the grave. Ah, God, if you can rescue me from the grave, I will not just read your word. Not only that, I will change. I will change and I will transform. I know that it's no point, God, no, right? Just reading your word and not transform, all right? I must transform to be more and more like you, right now. So I said, God, you know, right now, help me, please, no, right? Heal me, no, right now. Don't let me die. And I promise I will serve you. I will leave my advertising job completely and just serve you, right? I don't care, no, how, no, right, no, financially, no, right, no, it will come, no, I don't care, no, but I just know that, no, you will supply, right, no, God, no. And I then what I did was, no, I just, you know, concentrate, you know, every morning, you know, on my word therapy, right? Yeah. So when I concentrate on my word therapy, God will speak to me all the time, right? Yeah. And when God speaks to me, he will give me, you know, right, one verse, you know, of the day, you know. And the verse of the day, when downloaded to me, I will quickly go to my laptop, you know, type it out and paste it on the wall in my bedroom. You see? Then over time, you know, over a few months, the whole bedroom was filled with Bible verses, you know, wow, you know, pieces by pieces all on the wall, you know. I tell you, that time I was not good with the Bible, right now. But I know I have to make an effort. Because God said, I sent my word. I don't know your word, my God. I really don't know so well. What to do? No, so I have to spend time and focus, no, and spend, you know, really read God's word and paste it on the wall. And every morning I will wake up 5 a.m. 5 a.m. I wake up and kneel by the bedside. I kneel by the bedside and, you know, I read God's word. You know, God, you say this, you say that. God, you say this, you say that. You know, eventually, right now, yeah, I know more and more God's word. You know, when I know God's word, you know, God's word is spirit and it's life, and his spirit start to connect in my spirit. When his spirit start to connect with my spirit, I'm able to pray with the power of the Holy Spirit, you know, and be more powerful in commanding the cancer cells to die. Right? So I begin to pray things like, I lay hands on the tumor in the name of Jesus of Nazareth. I command the cancer cells to wither and die at its roots right now. This is the holy temple of God. I'm a child of God. No? As a child of God, no? God has blessed me with plans to prosper me, not to harm me. God has given me a hope, no, for the future, and to serve him and to glorify him. You know, so I pray like this. You know, even though I was so sick, even though I was so painful, no. I tell you, you don't know how pain I was suffering, you know, big time suffering. When I was undergoing chemotherapy and radiotherapy, even after the treatment, I was still in great pain because the tumor was still so big. The tumor was still so big and the whole chest wall was still filled with cancer cells, you know, right now. And I, you know how pain? I will take the maximum of painkillers, you know, the doctor has given me. In the night, it's still so pain, I couldn't sleep. I screamed, you know, right, so loud, you know, yeah, until I couldn't sleep, and I said, oh God, you know, right. Then I remember Jesus, you know. I yelled the name of Jesus, Jesus, you know. I remember Jeremiah 33:3, call unto me and I will answer you. I said, God, I'm calling you, answer me, take away my pain, you know, right, no, please, you know, you promised me you will answer me, you know, and indeed, each time I'm in great pain, you know, right, God came down from heaven. He's more or less is in the corner of a room, and the whole room was just so peaceful, you know. I tell you, it's like Jesus is standing there, you know, and then my pain just disappeared, just like that. I tell you, it's a miracle. It's a miracle. You know, how can the pain just disappear like that? But unfortunately, the next morning, the pain starts again. You know, in the middle of the night, I will scream again. Ah, I will call upon the name of Jesus, and Jesus will come again, and the pain will go again away, right now. So you see, you know, I thank God now, not for the cancer. I thank God for the journey of cancer. In this journey of cancer, I found God. In this journey of cancer, you know, I became intimate with God, you know, that I can really, you know, feel His presence. I can really talk to God. I can really feel the Holy Spirit, you know, right, working in me, you know, right? You know? And then, you know, I just went on like that, you know, right, worshiping the Lord, you know, and then one morning, as I was praying, God spoke to me and said, "No, Sherry, I want you to go and write a book. And this book is called There Is Hope." Right? Wow, God is so good, one. Why need to write a book? And someone give me the title of the book, There Is Hope. Right? I say, "God, no, how can I write a book? You have not healed me, you know. You have not healed me, right? I'm a 4th stage cancer patient. After I've written the book, I don't think people will buy the book. I will feel so disappointed, so sad, you know, and very ashamed. Nobody buys the book, you know. Yeah. But here God talking to me, write the book. So, right now, I remembered, you know, God said, I sent my word and healed your disease. So I thought to myself, if I were to write the book, I have to read the Bible. So I read, so I tell myself, hey, God's word can heal me, right? I must well write the book lah, right? So because I have to read God's word mah, so actually I said, God, no, right now, all right, no, I will obey you, because no, right now you have asked me to do so, I will obey. So thank you, Lord, for giving me the chance to read Genesis to Revelations. My whole life I never really read, you know. So what a privilege, no, to write a book for the Lord, no, and to be able to read, you know, beginning to the end of the Bible. So I read, you know, you have to do your research, you know, before you write the book, you know, right? Yeah? So after all these, you know, right now, so I wrote the book, and after it was written, it was launched in my church by my pastor. My pastor is Pastor Chu Wing Chi, by the way, of SIBKL. Oh, he's a great pastor, you know, right? He's my favorite pastor. I just simply love him, you know, yeah. No, I tell you, when I was sick that time, he and his wife, Pastor Liu Li Chu, came to my house one, you know, and they saw all the things pasted on the wall, God's word therapy. And they pray for me, you know, and even Pastor Chu is so simple and humble man. He really want me to live, you know, he didn't want me to die, you know. He would kneel by the bedside, you know, and really, you know, pleaded with God, you know, to let me live, you know. But as he prayed, God downloaded in his spirit, you know, that the Lord Jesus will heal me and you use me for greater purpose, you know, to bless others that many may be healed. He got that, you know, revelation from Jesus. That was the year 2007 when he prayed, you know. That time I was still down with cancer, very, very sick, yeah. Anyway, that's why I say he's such a wonderful pastor, really a man of God, a man after God's heart, you know. And anyway, going back, you know, to the book, you know, Pastor Chu, you know, helped me launch the book together with me. That was in June 2007. Yeah? So in June 2007, after it was published, you know, yeah, I went back to my closet, you know, back home. I said, God, I've written the book already. No, weeks and weeks have passed. No, I'm still suffering. I'm still in great pain. I know the tumor is still so big there. Why have you not healed me, Lord? No, right now. I thought I strike a bargain with you. I obey you, no, and you will heal me. The Lord was silent, completely silent. Did not answer me, no, right? Instead, I tell you, you won't believe it. No? God spoke to me and said, Sherry, now I want you to go and start a cancer support group. My goodness, you know, right now, to start a cancer support group, I was still then a 4th stage cancer patient. And I said, God, now I don't have the energy, No, I don't have the resources. No, I don't even have a place to start. No, I know. And I'm in great pain. I'm walking, you know, with a like a, with a tongka, with a stick like that. No, how can I go out? You know, and I can't drive. You know, right? Aiyo, but I tell you, every morning when I wake up and, you know, seek the Lord say, I want you to start. I want you to start. I want you to start. And then, you know, aiyah, you know, I keep saying no, 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 no way, you know, because I'm going to be awfully shy, you know. You think anybody will turn up, you know, when I'm a dying fourth stage cancer patient, you know? What am I doing to start a cancer support group, you know? But wow, God was so insistent for me to start. Then, as I pray, you know, prayer is a two-way communication. Then I start to ask God, oh God, why? Oh, God spoke to me. And God said, no, as you comfort others, you yourself will be comforted. As you refresh others, you yourself will be refreshed. As you pray for others, you yourself will get the healing. Wow, God, you mean as I pray for others, I can get the healing? I want to be healed, or I don't want to die. So I quickly get started, because I don't want to die. I started the cancer support group, you know, right? And then on that day, I prayed, you know, I said, you know, pray hard, I said, God, let there be people. Let there be people. And true enough, God was good. God sent 12 people there. 10 plus 2, 12. 12 people, you know, to the cancer support group. Not so bad, God didn't put me to shame. Praise God. No? Yeah, no, so 12 people came, and most of them were cancer patients. No? And that cancer support group actually was called the El Piso Cancer Support Group. L stands for God. Piso stands for I hope. It's a Greek word. So I hope in God, a Greek word, El Piso Cancer Support Group, right? So the cancer support group was started, and I begin, you know, to minister to the sick, you know, and visit the sick people, you know, at the cancer patients at home. And thank God I got a good friend, you know, who drive me here and there to visit the sick people, you know, praise the Lord, you know, right? And after, you know, all the setup for the cancer support group, you know, 2 months later, I started, by the way, in July 2007, the cancer support group. 2 months later, in September 2007, I went for a CT scan. And I tell you, no, right, it is miracle number one. Miracle number one, right? Because, no, the cancer tumor I told you all just now was 6x7x4 cm, this large. Suddenly, after starting the cancer support group for just 2 months, suddenly it reduced by 70%. This tumor just zoom, not left only 30%. But I said, Lord, this 30% is still cancer, leh. It's still cancer, no? You have not healed me, no? Yeah, I still feel uncomfortable, still kind of a little bit in pain here and there, no? Right now. But I again hear the Lord saying to me, no, right now, by my stripes, you were healed. Right? Says God, no? Yeah. In 2 months, no, it went down by 70%. So this 30%, I should not worry. I'm sure one day it will disappear. So I just continued serving the Lord in the El Piso Cancer Support Group for the 1 year until August 2008. And in August 2008, no, I went for another CT scan. Ah, I tell you, right, God is faithful. God is good. God is awesome. God is merciful. God is amazing. Right, a true miracle happened. All the cancer cells disappear. The tumor, the left, the 30%, totally disappear. Not a trace of cancer. And the doctor was so surprised, no? The doctor said, oh, you must be one of the lucky few. I told the doctor, I don't think I'm one of the lucky few. I just want to share with you, right? My Lord Jesus healed me, right? And this miracle is made possible through the Lord Jesus Christ. No? Because now Jesus is the same yesterday, today, and forever. He healed in the seas of Galilee, right? 2,000 years ago. He heals today. He's the same. There's miracle, you know, today, modern day miracles. So as you can see in Evelyn's book, there were many miracles. So yeah, right. So Jesus is real, right? Jesus is real. He's a living God. He's not a God that people, you know, say, oh, he's a God and he's died already, you know, right now. And that's it, he's a human being, you see the bones, right? But this is different. Jesus was resurrected on the third day, right? You can never find his bones, no? And he has prepared a mansion for us in heaven, right? For those who accept Christ, so, you have eternal life. I was so scared of dying. I tell you, the last time I didn't know where my spirit would be going. But today, my heart is steadfast. My spirit is steadfast, trusting in the Lord, because I know my spirit, you know, right now, will not die. I will have eternal life. For my spirit is only a change of address, you know, from the earth to heaven. That's it, you know, right? And it's so beautiful to be a Christian. It's so beautiful to be a child of God, you know, right? And I tell you right now, I was so overjoyed, and of course I continue to serve the Lord, you know, in the Elpizo Cancer Support Group, you know. And then not only that, many of my church friends, you know, and churches, you know, heard of this miracle, you know. They invited me to their church, and I just went around to many churches until today. I went to about 50 churches already, right? To testify of God's goodness, you know? Yeah. And I'm very happy one, you know, to go to churches or anywhere, and I'm very happy being with you now, right? Now, yeah, you know why? Because each time, right, you share your testimony, right, Satan is defeated. Because in Revelation 12:11, it says that, you know, Satan is defeated by the blood of the Lamb and the word of your testimony, right? So the more you testify, the more you glorify God, you know, the stronger you become, right? You know, because, you know, God honors His word, yeah? You know? And I tell you, in churches, I always share this, you know, I'm so happy to share today because of Genesis 50:20. Genesis 50:20 says, you know, that, you know, right now, you meant to harm me, but God meant, you know, it for good, to accomplish what is now being done, the saving of many lives. You see, right now? Mm-hmm. So, even when I was down in 2006-2007, I saw this verse, you know. I saw Genesis 50:20. I hung on this, you know, tight to my chest, you know, right? You know, that God, you know, you are going to use me one day, you know, for the saving of many lives, you know, and the healing of many people, right? You are going to use me, O Lord, you know, right now? And you see, you need to believe, you need to have a hope, you know, right now? Then you will strive on. Although your body is like dying, you know, yeah, although the doctor says like, oh, that's all I can do, right? Don't take the doctor's word as the last word. God's word is the last word, you know, right? No matter how you feel, you know, don't give in to your feeling. Faith has nothing to do with feeling. Feelings have nothing to do with faith, you know. Faith has everything to do with the word of God. You see that? No, right now. So, you know, I just, you know, right, went to many churches, you know, and not only that, you know, it's so good. My friends in the advertising circle heard of my miracle, right? You know, and they say, hey, can I interview for this magazine, well, for that newspaper? But there I say, no, of course, you know, right? You know, and I appeared in many, many newspapers and many magazines in full color, right? Can you imagine in full color? It would cost how many hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of thousands, you know, right? You know? Yeah, but I got this all for free. Free advertising for Jesus. You know, praise the Lord, you know, I tell you, right? You know? Yeah, you know, and I'll just say that, you know, my God heals me, but my God is who? Is the Lord Jesus Christ. My God is not any ordinary God. It's the Lord Jesus Christ who heals me and give me this modern day miracle, right? You know? Yeah. And so, you know, right, you know, so I went around to many churches and many newspapers, magazines, you know, they invited me. I mean, it was published everywhere. Ayo, I tell you, then so many people now come to know of the Elpizo Cancer Support Group. And today we meet in SIBKL, the church the church I worship, twice a month, each time we come together. It's not 12 people anymore, right? No. Wow, there will be 60, 70, no, lots of sick people. And we rename it. We rename from the Elpizo Cancer Support Group to Elpizo Healing Ministry. Because, you know, I say, God, if you can heal cancer people, you can heal people with all kinds of sicknesses, you know, right? Including Evelyn's father, you know. Evelyn's father, you know, came to the Elpizo Cancer Support Group. That's how I came to know Evelyn Tan, you know. And her father was suffering from big time, I tell you, the very pain, and he saw all kinds of doctors, Chinese doctors, English doctors, for easily 20 years suffering like that, you know, right? And, you know, one day he came to Elpizo, you know, and the prayer team, we have our prayer team there, pray for him. And one guy, you know, in the prayer team, his name is Brother Joshua. Brother Joshua laid hands, you know, on Uncle Tan, you know. And wow, instantly that day he was healed. My goodness, right now. And today, you know, right now, he's free of pain, you know, right now. Just so happy, you know, whenever he comes to Elpizo, even now today, you know. Ayo, I see his radiant smile. I can feel, you know, even the presence of God in Uncle Tan, so strong nowadays, you know. He was so grateful until today. I can see that he's radiating with gratefulness from his heart, from his face, you know, for the Lord Jesus to heal him, you know. Just like me, I'm so grateful, you know. That's why, you know, I always tell myself I will serve the Lord until my last breath, you know, right, you know. Yeah, you know, and many people, when they come to Elpizo, they are healed all kinds of cancer, right, you know. Fourth stage, third stage, whatever stage, you know. Our God is a God of no stage, right? Huh? Whatever stage also He can heal. And not just breast cancer or whatnot, all kinds of cancer, you know. Can you imagine even pancreatic cancer? Pancreatic cancer usually sure die one, I tell you. Pancreatic cancer, the Lord heal one lady. Stomach cancer heal one man, although he's cut off half of his stomach, right? Huh? Another guy cut off half his lung, he's still surviving after so many years. Lung cancer, brain cancer, God also heal. Colon cancer also, you know, thyroid cancer, breast cancer. Whatever cancer you name, you know, God heals, right? And not only cancer, as I said, Evelyn's father, you know, the backache, the back pain. And also there was one lady who couldn't hear, you know. Wow, you know, 4 or 5 years couldn't hear. That day she was prayed for instantly, right? You know, pop, you know, she could hear, right? You know? And there was one man also on wheelchair, he couldn't walk, you know. Yeah, after all the prayers, he went home and started, you know, to walk a bit, you know. Yeah, all kinds of healing takes place, you know. And quite a number of people who have depression, they also got healed, you know. And by the way, a lady, I tell you, you know, she got depression 5 years already. She's in Penang. She read my book, you know. She accepted Christ after reading my book, just like that, you know. Yeah? And you know, she also, you know, was after accepting Christ, you know, a short while later, her depression disappeared. You know? She read my second book, lah. Because after I was healed, you know, I wrote my second book. There is hope, you know. I wrote my second book. I should have got my book here, right, to show you, you know, right now. Maybe later, you know, after the video, I can show my book. You know, I produced the book, and this book has blessed so many people. Many people have emailed me, phoned me, you know, even in the Elpizo Cancer Support Group, tell me that, you know, how the Lord sometimes healed them just through reading of the book. And now how their fear went away just by reading the book. A lady in Malacca, now she was in great fear. Now every time she feared, no, and she just read my book, put it under the pillow and sleep with the book. She slept with my book for 6 months. After she slept with my book for 6 months, she went for a scan. The cancer disappeared. My goodness, I was so happy for her, you know. Rah. Another Hindu lady, she's about 70, 80, I think. No, she got fourth stage cancer. She read my book. She's a Hindu, by the way. She read my book. After she read my book, she wrote me a letter. And the letter says something like that. Dear Sherry, you know, yeah, I'm so glad, you know, to have read your book. You know, and you know, I've come to know Jesus, you know, and I have much peace. Yeah. And that's it. And then I think she passed away. Yeah, she passed away. The letter was never posted to me. But how I know about the letter? Her daughter one day was doing spring cleaning, found the book and saw the letter in the book, and then emailed to me and tell me, wow, my mom wrote this letter to you that was never posted. Wow, praise God. Huh? I never saw her. I think one day I'll see her in heaven. Huh? Yeah, no, yeah. Wow, so many stories. I produced a DVD also. And in this DVD, you know, right, many were touched, you know, many cried, and many accepted the Lord. You know? One of my cell members, she took this DVD, went to a lady's house, you know, she got fourth stage cancer. She's almost also 70, 80, you know, yeah. And she saw the DVD with my friend, with her husband, with her daughter, and with her son-in-law, right? Halfway watching the DVD, the Spirit of God just came down and filled the whole house and their hearts, you know, and they were crying and crying and crying, you know. And just halfway, you know, right, my friend, you know, just asked, you know, right now, would you like to accept the Lord Jesus Christ? All four of them instantly accept the Lord Jesus Christ. My goodness, it's amazing, right? You know? Soon after this, old lady passed away, but thank God, you know, she's in heaven. She's, you know, enjoying her life in Jesus, eternal life, you know. Wow, you see, you know, right, I say, God, you know, right now, I was just, you know, so broken. I was dying in 2006, you know, right now. You just use me, you know, right now. And I'm not a fantastic writer, but people say my book's so fantastic, you know, right now. Yeah, no, you just enable me to write, you know, right now. You just use me, you know, and every time I write, I pray, and you seem to pen the words for me, you know. Thank you, Lord, you know, right now. And it just touched the hearts of many, you know. Today is touching so many people, you know, even around the world, you know. And people got healed, you know, and got saved, you know. Lord, you know, I thank you, right? I thank you, lucky God, I was obedient to you. If I, this girl, was not obedient to you, right now, I probably wouldn't have today. thousands and thousands of people would not have read my book, would not have accepted the Lord Jesus Christ. I tell you, no, God, you're so good. Thank you, Lord, right now. So I want to share with you one thing about this El Piso Healing Ministry. Many came right now, and many were healed by the Lord Jesus Christ. The good thing is, after they were healed, a number of them went back to their own churches. By the way, the healing ministry is not just for SIBKL, for all churches, anybody can come. They went back to their own church, and they started their own cancer support group. In total now, in KL and BJ, six cancer support groups have started in other churches as a result of the El Piso Healing Ministry. As a result, they came to El Piso, got healed by the Lord, and went back to start their own cancer support group. Isn't God amazing? Isn't God amazing? No, right, as you look at me now, right, you're looking at the picture of health. You see, I am very blessed. I'm very joyful serving the Lord. And the Lord, since 2006 to now, 2017, how many years already? 11 years. So the Lord has used me 11 years already. Even my latest scan, every year I do my scan, I'm completely free of cancer. But I praise the Lord. And I'm never scared going for scan. Every time I go for scan, I sing hymns inside, because I say all will be fine, right? And indeed always come out to be fine, And not only 11 years, I want to tell you, my first bout of cancer, as I shared just now in the tape, was when I was 38 years old. So now, already 23 years passed. 23 years, have passed. So don't take the doctor's word as the last word. Take God's word as the last word. When you take God's word as the last word, you surrender your life to Jesus, and do the will of God now. You see, today is a modern day miracle. So that's my miracle I'm sharing with you. And thank you for Evelyn. Evelyn is so wonderful to give me this opportunity to share my miracle, right? Indeed, the Lord Jesus is the living God. Amen. Hallelujah. And now I just want to share with you the book which I've written after I got my complete healing, The Miracle from the Lord Jesus Christ. Here you go. This is the English version. And the title of the book is There Is Hope. And the subtitle says, The Amazing Story of One Woman's Victory Over Cancer Through the Power of Faith. You read about this modern day miracle in this English book. I also have got a Chinese version. Here you go. This is the Chinese version of There Is Hope. And on top of the English and the Chinese books, I've also produced a DVD. Not a CD, alright? A DVD, you can see the pictures. It's like a movie, right? There you are. No? Hope Through Faith is the title of the DVD. And this is an amazing story of one woman's victory over cancer through the Lord Jesus Christ. And where can you get the DVD and the book? You can get them at two bookstores in Malaysia. One is Canon Land and the other one is Salvation Bookstore. You can just Google and get their address if you wish them to mail to you, or you can just go to their bookstores, Salvation Bookstore and Canon Land, to buy the books and the DVD. Or if you wish, you can email me direct. I can always direct you where to buy, or find out more information about the El Piso Healing Ministry at my church, SIBKL. By all means, email me. And my email address is sherrylim01@yahoo.com. It's spelled as sherrylim01@yahoo.com. There you go. Just get in touch, with the book, with myself, and you'll be in touch with the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.